we're towards us, and it's meant to keep us here. So you're right, because, you know, if they lose citizens, they lose tax money. I mean, that's why this whole illegal alien process is even a thing, because the U.S. of A Corporation wants to put everybody under a Social Security number, and that makes them a citizen, and then that makes them all of their wages subject to tax. They don't care that people are coming here and earning a living. They just want to make tax payment on it. So, you know, they want to document everybody and, you know, dock them into their vessel. It's very maritime admiralty law. So that's just that whole game that they're playing, you know.
I think it goes around from the New World Order. It's all been planned out for a long time.
Yeah, totally. Oh, a long time. Even the world wars that we're in, we've been in so far, like, we're just getting out of the global war on terror, which is World War III, and now Trump is heading us into the space, the alien invasion war, getting ready with Space Command. I mean, you can see it all played out, and I've mentioned Albert Pike, a Freemason, who wrote the doctrine for these three world wars and submitted them to the government, or the U.S. of A. Corporation, and they've been following his plan. If you look up the information on Albert Pike and his letter to the head of the mafia, Mazzini, he lays it all out. And, you know, Albert Pike is instrumental in Freemasonry, where he wrote, you know, Morals and Dogma, and it's the foundation of their Freemasonry ceremonies. So, if you look at all of the different, you know, symbolism on the government buildings and the obelisks that they use, it's all falls under Maritime Admiralty and the Freemasonry stone builders who have been controlling everything. And this has all been laid out and is following a strict, pretty much, you know, their time frame, but it's all playing out. And now this global war on terror kind of officially ended when they said that they threw Osama bin Laden's body into the ocean. And now they've just been, you know,
so they say they threw it in the ocean.
Yeah, exactly. And I don't think that they did. I just think that bin Laden was just a guy who played that role. And he was, the bin Laden family were very close business associates with the Bush family. And this whole thing is being orchestrated by, you know, both the Bushes and the Crown of England and the Vatican. And it's all been laid out and it's working. I mean, I'm doing my best getting on your show and other shows to just get the word out there that there's a solution, you know, that we actually can keep it from going so far out of control where we're slaves to where we can get on at least equal financial footing.
Well, we
that's
need
one of my goals.
We need to do something. We need to do something now, because where I am really frustrated at, okay, this administration, okay, putting their tariffs right on China. You know what is the most craziest thing in the world? I mean, the least the amounts they're doing it, it's childish how this president is doing it. Now, I'm not saying I'm against Trump. I'm not saying I'm for Trump. But I'm saying the way he's handling this is bad, because you know what? You're going to start seeing prices on electronics going up very shortly. Big time. And not that. I gotta say this, and I'll let you say everything you want to say tonight, Ronald. I got a feather up my, you know what, tonight. Because I'm looking at, you know, people can't find decent paying jobs. Now, with these tariffs coming up, right? That means now the people, I'm not talking about rich people. Yeah, middle class is not really middle class anymore. And then we have, poor people out there that make it from paycheck to paycheck. What are they going to do when they're stuff? They go even in the Dollar Tree, dollar stores, right? Well, what's going to happen to those stores? Because a lot of that stuff, again, is going to be hit with tariffs. They're not going to be able to sell the stuff for a dollar. Like I mentioned before, I didn't even know there was a TV manufacturer in our country yet. I thought Curtis Matthews was the last company 30 years ago went out of business because of China and Korea and all this stuff, right? Making TVs. They were the last company making TVs in this country. I was dead wrong. There was a company down south that still was making TVs. And they are now closing and laying off their employees. Why? Because, well, most of their TVs didn't sell in our country. They sold over in China and some other places. Then a lot of their parts they had to secure because we don't make a lot of these parts anymore in this country, comes from China. So he had 100 and some employees. They're all going to be without a job. He's not going to have a business anymore. So that's the last company in this country making TVs. We don't make toasters. We don't make irons. But now, what type of jobs is there? Working at McDonald's, Burger King, and Denny's. You know, and that's what scares me. Now, putting these tariffs on are going to hurt people. It's going to hurt people bad. And you know what? That means when they need to go out and buy something, they're not going to be able to afford it because the prices are so high. And, you know, and then a lot of the companies here can't export their stuff now to China because they won't want to buy it over there because of the tariffs. So now that's hurting the farmers and it's hurting a whole bunch of other people. Hey, we'll give them some fake money, you know, to keep the farmers going. But you know what? It's crazy what we're doing. We're not accomplishing anything. The jobs are going to go away. Our economy, I've been reading a lot. Our economy is a bubble, way worse than the last bubble. We're going into a depression, my friend, not a recession. We're going to go into a depression shortly. And some of the stuff that is being done is the most craziest things I ever seen in my entire life. And creating jobs. Oh, wow. Then, my last thing I'm going to say. The tax break that they gave you, me, and the people down the street, right? How many of these people, right? Next year, it comes April, they didn't take enough money out to cover their taxes. And now, what's going to happen? They're going to owe. They're going to owe the money. They're going to owe for not paying on time. So they get a penalty there. Then they're going to get another. They're going to get at least two penalties plus having to pay the money. And they're going to be in shock, and especially the people like on Social Security or lower income people, you know, they're going to have to go to what, one of these places and take a payroll advance or go to one of these places and get a loan for 32% just to pay the IRS. And they're already going to be paying the IRS a nice hefty penalty. It's crazy. And even the IRS don't even know how to even structure it yet. They figure it's going to take another year to structure out, you know, this mess that it was created. That is my input. And I blame a lot of this off because, you know what? Somebody's trying to keep their promise, but the way they're doing it is going to hurt our country. And the New World Order, I didn't believe it. A friend of mine, Art Bell, you know, off the side, a lot of times told me that there is a new world order. And I kind of, you know, after we had our little phone conversation, I kind of chuckle afterwards. You know that, Ronald? I figured, hey, you know, he's really wrapped up in his show. Well, I come to a conclusion, a big conclusion. They're trying to thin out the population. They're trying to, well, do everything they can to hurt us.
You know, when you say that Art Bell said there is the new world order, there is a new world order, I bet when he said it, he sounded very sincere, like he knew for sure that he was told firsthand.
Well, I he had a lot of guests on him talking about the new world order. And I guess when you start, you know, researching it, and that's what I've been doing. You know, I've been sick this past week of the flu. So I've been doing a lot of reading on the news, what's going on. And I'll tell you something, besides being sick with the flu, I actually got emotionally sick because, how can I say it? You take lambs to the slaughter. The people out here don't realize what's happening. And I don't want to sound like I've changed my talk show because, you know, I'm the same person, but I have my own political and non-political views. I'm just saying people here don't realize between the climate, financially, job-wise, what's going to happen? And it's going to happen sooner than later, my friend.
And not to mention the rate of sickness due to malnutrition, diabetes, because all of a sudden over the past 10 years, they've genetically modified everything we're eating. And the findings and studies on genetically modified food, what they do to people, is just, it's lethal. We're actually being exterminated like several different ways at the same time. And I don't know if your audience has ever, all of them know about the Georgia Guidestones. I actually put them in my movie Hollywood and Vine on purpose because the Messiah goes to try and save the world in Hollywood to publish a book that's supposed to just end war and poverty, which is what I'm in the middle of doing. And they are suddenly poisoning us to death with everything, the air, with chemtrails and food. So it's adding insult to injury with what you were saying about this poverty that we're intentionally being put into. And it's completely manufactured. I mean, this poverty thing is really just made up by the corporations that are posing as governments, using the fiat currency system that the Federal Reserve banking system is printing off and making everybody earn per hour, and to buy the poison now that they're feeding us, and to rent land and homes from them because they still control all the titles. They can come and throw you out of your house at any time with their police power. That's why I say the beginning of a free country, Einstein said, is when the youth of that nation refuse military service. It's almost like we have to stand down and stop supporting these psychopaths that are in the middle of doing their best to fulfill the first commandment on the new of the New World Order, which is listed on the Georgia Guidestones in Georgia. I called up to find out who built these, and it wasn't difficult to find out, but it's basically these local low-name politicians in that area that have created what some people believe is New World Order East. With these earth changes and weather changes going on, they're saying the Mississippi River might overflow drastically soon and divide the United States landmass into two separate halves, with New World Order East in Georgia at the Georgia Guidestones as a cornerstone, and New World Order West in Denver, Colorado, underneath Denver International Airport.
I don't know. I am so frustrated. Now, why don't you tell the listenership here how long you worked for the DOD? Let's give some credibility to you here.
I went into the Army in 1993 as a signals intelligence analyst and a Korean linguist, and I worked at the top secret level for 15 years. I worked 8 years active duty Army intelligence. I was stationed in Korea. I was stationed at Headquarters Central Command and basically did a lot of reporting and technical intelligence gathering on surveillance satellites over the Central Command AOR, or Area of Responsibility of the Middle East. And that was all during right leading up to 9/11. In fact, one of my last days on active duty was when Tommy Franks gave a briefing on September 7th, 2001, right before 9/11, and saying that our biggest threat was domestic terrorism by Islamic radicals within the United States. And then, boom, 4 days later, 9/11 attacks. And so after I got out around just after 9/11, I became a contractor, and I worked at Headquarters Special Operations Command and managed intelligence databases, and I trained Special Forces analysts how to exploit intelligence in the global AOR, because Headquarters Special Operations Command is there in Florida at MacDill Air Force Base, and Special Operations are global, so I managed a global joint Pentagon SOCOM intelligence database, and then I trained intelligence analysts on how to exploit that information for actionable operations. And then while I was training those intel analysts, I wound up resigning because I had submitted a plan to stop terrorism globally to the National Security Agency and the CIA and the Department of Defense in a point paper that I gave them, a layout of how to stop terrorist activity, and they wanted to pull me off my contract like the very next day because I had a solution to end the war on terror, like, right around 2004, 2006. And so I resigned instead, and then I decided to figure out a way to stop war and end this whole poverty mess, which I figured out on how to do that, how we can pretty much become our own Federal Reserve.
Well, why don't you tell the people out there how they can become their own Federal Reserve?
Well, here's the deal. Everybody was immediately converted into a corporation when they were born, and your documentation is your birth certificate. You have trusts, several trusts that you manage, and one of them is your birth certificate trust, which is a commodity. And so you're a corporation. That's your article of incorporation. That's your trust that you're responsible for, And so you can autograph things for that trust and make paperwork and sign checks and write currency. Just like the Federal Reserve is a corporation and the United States of America is a